A big congratulations to Vasily Lomachenko after getting robbed against Devin Haney. Thinking about retirement. Disappointing. People made fun of him for crying after that fight and all kinds of nasty things. Comes back and totally redeems himself. Goes all the way to Australia. Fights a guy that Devin Haney beat twice in 12 rounds. Devin couldn't stop George Kambosos. Loma at 36, after being out of the ring for a long time, after saying that he's going to end his career, that he was done with boxing, gets the knockout in the 11th round after dominating the entire fight. I don't think he lost a second of the fight. And the scorecards reflected it, with the judges each giving Kambosos 1 to 2 rounds max. But even that was them being generous. If you look at the punch stats, Kambosos threw less than 8 punches a round. You can't tell me you ran around with 8 punches when your opponent's throwing 20, 30 punches, 40 punches. It doesn't work like that. It's, you know, it is what it is. But Loma definitely pulled it off, and the future is bright. He's now the IBF champion at 135. And this is what the championship looks like for 135, how it breaks down. The WBA champ is Gervonta Davis. WBC champ is Shakur Stevenson. The IBF is Vasily Lomachenko. The WBO championship will be between Navarrete and Baranchuk, and that's going down a week from tonight. And that's going to be very interesting to see who wins that. And, you know, maybe we'll see another undisputed here. Gervonta Davis was watching the fight like most of us, and during the fight, he answered a tweet from a fan that said he would never fight Loma. He said, after Frank Martin, I'm fighting Loma. And Loma said this about Tank calling him out. You know, during my boxing career, I never ran around. I've always taken fights. After I rest a bit, we could talk about the future. So he didn't say yes. He didn't say no. But he said, hey, I don't turn down fights. And that would be a massive fight. Coach Kenny Ellis, one of the coaches of Gervonta Davis, had this to say. He posted it on his social media. And he says, Lomachenko won't get past 6 rounds with Gervonta Davis. Tank will knock his butt all up in a tree with them koala bears. During this week, Kenny, by the way, is a huge animal person. If he didn't work in boxing, he'd be working with animals somewhere. But during the week, Lomachenko held a koala, and he said the koala was half dog, half cat. That's what the impression he got. But Loma's a big animal person, too. Richardson Hitchens, very witty guy, very funny guy, just said, George Kambosos, how it feel this one of your last good paydays in my sport, you bum. Kambosos talked a lot of trash, where he's really not a very good fighter. Lost to Haney's twice. And by the way, Haney's resume doesn't get better by Loma stopping a guy that he couldn't stop twice. Like I started this video, Loma beat Haney. He got robbed that night. Just unbelievable, the sport of boxing sometimes, how people get robbed when they clearly win. But it does happen. And that's a perfect example. So, Richardson goes on to post Cambodi. Listen, if you talk a lot of trash, and Kambosos was talking so much trash to Richardson Hitchens, it's, hey, if you dish, you should receive. Be fair. If you talk trash, listen, I talk trash. I picked Spence to beat Crawford. Crawford won and gave me a shout-out on stage and said I don't look very smart. But I earned it. I'm not going to complain about it because I talk trash. You know, it goes back and forth. I could appreciate someone that, you know, goes with the banter versus someone who just can't handle it, which there's a lot of that too. Clarissa Shields says, okay, Lomachenko, congrats. Everyone loves Loma, and I haven't seen anyone post anything bad about Lomachenko. He's just a very hard worker. He's a good person. And he works very, very hard. And this one was for his son. He dedicated the win, the championship, to his dad, who didn't want him to quit boxing. And his son wanted him to be a champ. We all saw, I remember, Devin Haney making fun of Loma crying in the locker room. And I thought that was wrong of showing that video. Anyways, that was his private moment. But we live in a day and age where it's all out there. So Devin Haney was making fun of Loma crying, and now there's a lot of memes of Devin crying after the fight. So beautiful, Tariata says, beautiful scene with Loma, his father, and Loma's son, ring of life. As I just mentioned, Loma did not retire for his dad, out of respect for his dad, and he wanted to give his son a belt, and his son got a championship belt tonight. If there's one thing I could fix about boxing, it would be the scoring, it would be the refereeing, it would be if a referee is incompetent, if a judge is incompetent, if they don't do their job and they affect the fighter's life, forget A-side, B-side, promoter, fighter. Go with the truth. The Lakers score 90, the Clippers score 100. It's clearly who won in every sport except boxing. Boxing is so up to interpretation, and it's wrong because, and I'm saying corruption, I'm not saying politics, but unfortunately, there's a lot of it, and then people start saying that it's politics and saying that it's corruption. So there has to be a way. Maybe do 5 judges. Maybe do 7 judges. 3 judges is not working. Maybe do health checks for referees. And like in the NBA, other sports, check the financials that are referees, that no one's bribing them, that they're not getting hundreds of thousands of dollars under the table, which I don't know if it's the case or not. But you definitely, just like fighters have to do full physical, I would like judges and referees to do full physicals to make sure they're not addicted to drugs, make sure they can see, they can hear, make sure they're in good physical condition to perform their best job. So Teofimo Lopez says, congratulations. He talks in Spanish to Loma and Loma's manager, although they speak English, Russian, and Ukrainian. Felicidad. So, Vasily Lomachenko. Bob Arum said that he would like to do Lomachenko and Shakur because Shakur has a fight in July against Artem Ovanisian, the last guy who fought Frank Martin, and Shakur just beat George Kambosos. And Bob Arum says if they each win their fights, they can meet and fight each other. And Shakur had some words here because the network, ESPN, did not really push for that fight, which may or may not happen. We don't know. But first, the next big fight that's coming up, Gervonta Davis, June 15 against Frank Martin. And after that, we'll know what's the next step. Shakur then fighting in July. If everybody keeps winning their fights, we're definitely going to have unification bouts here, or we're going to have not only unification bouts, but I could see fighters going to 40, fight for title, back to 35, up and down, back and forth, and a lot of crisscross. Now, speaking of Devin Haney, the WBC announced today that he has a mandatory. It's going to go to purse bid, him and Sandor Martin. And the split on a purse bid could be 70-30, 80-20, 60-40, whatever it is, if they come to a purse bid agreement. If not, some promoter will have to bid on it. Sandor Martin at this point beats Devin Haney. Devin Haney right now is not in a good place to fight. He's not. He needs a year off, if not longer. Sandor Martin is a good fighter. He gave Teofimo hell, and he beat Mikey Garcia. So Devin Haney may think that's an easy fight, but the best thing for him now is to vacate the belt, take time off, and come back in a year and see where he is. Right now, I think he's there for the picking, and it may not be pretty, even if Sandor Martin doesn't have a lot of power. And you got to be real. Sandor Martin is not a fight that anybody wants to see Haney be in. They want to see he's the champion. He got to fight the other champs, which is Teofimo, which is Subriel Matias. And I'm missing one champ at 40. Subriel Matias, Devin Haney, Teofimo. And, of course, how could I forget? Pitbull Cruz, sorry. Pitbull Cruz is fighting August 3rd in Los Angeles against Ryu. That's a 50-50 fight. After the first 3-4 months of this year that were crazy slow, things are picking up and it's looking great. We just had a tremendous fight with Canelo, now with Loma, and we're going to have Gervonta Davis, and David Benavides is on the card as well. He's fighting Fosdick, and so many. Then we have Usyk and Fury coming up next weekend, and so many big fights coming up. The sport is going to thrive and blow up. And then, of course, July 20th, for the people, like it or not, Mike Tyson is fighting Jake Paul. That's going to bring boxing a huge boost as well. And then what about the fights like Bam Rodriguez and Gaio Estrada? Which Estrada fans are reaching out to me. They're all butthurt that I said that Gaio will get knocked out or stopped the first time. But I think Bam is that good. And if I'm wrong, hey, come after me after the fight. But if I'm right, just wait and see. So there you have it. Stay tuned. FaceReporting.com. I'm Ellie Secback reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter at Secback. You can follow me on Instagram at Ellie Secback. Secback, Ellie Secback reporting. But ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Ellie Secback reporting. ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Ellie Secback reporting. I'm Ellie Secback, Ellie Secback reporting. But ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Eli Sekback reporting.
ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Eli Sekback reporting.